Good morning, everyone. We're going to go ahead and get started. I hope you all are having a great day today. Let me know if you're watching in the chat. Tell me who's watching, which houses are watching. So for our first activity for today, we're going to go ahead and go over our calendar. So can anyone tell me what day of the week today is? Feel free to type it in the chat. If you said Friday, you are correct. I unfortunately don't have a calendar, so I'm going to work with what I have. I'm writing it down for you guys. Today is Friday. I'm going to go ahead and play a special song for today and let me know if you guys know it.
This is how we do it.
Today is Friday, and this is how we do it on Friday. Okay, so since today is Friday, can anyone tell me what tomorrow is or what tomorrow will be? Today is Friday. Since today is Friday, tomorrow will be Saturday. Now for the weather, it looks, well, before I close my blinds, or whatever those are called, curtains, it looked like it was really sunny outside. Feel free to type in the chat what it looks like outside everyone else's window. The weather is sunny. Yesterday was October 29th. So what day does that make today? What is today's date? If yesterday was October 29th. Since yesterday was October 29th, that makes today October 30th of 2020. And since today is October 30th, can anyone tell me what tomorrow's holiday is? If you guys guessed Halloween, you are correct. So I'm kind of in the Halloween spirit. I'm wearing my Star Wars shirt with Baby Yoda. I love Star Wars. So now we're going to go ahead and move on to our next activity, which is movement. For movement, we're going to do the Macarena. So everyone go ahead and stand up, get ready to dance and move. Go ahead and stand up, you guys. So remember, for the Macarena, we're going to start with our hands. We're going to go to the
cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Que tu cuerpo está dando la alegría y cosa buena. Baila tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Macarena. Ay. Baila tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Que tu cuerpo está dando la alegría y cosa buena. Baila tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Macarena. Ay. Macarena tiene un novio que se llama. Que se llama de apellido Vitorino. En la jura de bandera del muchacho. Se la dio con dos amigos. Ay. Macarena tiene un novio que se llama. Que se llama de apellido Vitorino. Que es la jura de bandera del muchacho. Se la dio con dos amigos. Ay. Baila tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Que tu cuerpo es para dar la alegría y cosas buenas. Baila tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Macarena. Ay. Baila tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Que tu cuerpo es para dar la alegría y cosas buenas. Baila tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Macarena. Ay. Macarena, Macarena, Macarena. ¿Te gustan los veranos de Marbella? Macarena, Macarena, Macarena. ¿Te gusta la movida guerrillera? ¡Ay! ¡Ay! Baila tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Que tu cuerpo es para dar la alegría y cosas buenas. Baila tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Macarena. ¡Ay! Baila tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Que tu cuerpo es para dar la alegría y cosas buenas. Baila tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Macarena. Ay. Macarena sueña con el corte inglés y se compra los modelos más modernos. Le gustaría vivir en Nueva York y ligar un novio nuevo. Ay. Macarena sueña con el corte inglés y se compra los modelos más modernos. Le gustaría vivir en Nueva York y ligar un novio nuevo. Ay. Baila tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Que tu cuerpo es para dar la alegría y cosas buenas. Baila tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Macarena. Ay. Baila tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Que tu cuerpo es para dar la alegría y cosas buenas. Baila tu cuerpo, alegría, Macarena. Macarena. Ay. Macarena tiene un loco que...
Great job, you guys. All right. Now, for our next activity, we're going to do another guessing game. I know you guys did one with Alyssa a couple days ago. But today's category, it's going to be Halloween focus, similar to Alyssa's. But we're going to focus on the creatures or people of Halloween. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is describe some creatures. And I want you guys to let me know what you think the answer is. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have 5. So I'm gonna go ahead and get started. The first one is a creature that really loves the taste of blood. It has pointy teeth, usually right around here. Sometimes they wear a cape, and sometimes they can turn into a bat and fly. What do you guys think that creature is? It's really sensitive to the sun. Likes the taste of blood, pointy teeth, can fly, really sensitive to the sun. If you guys guess vampire, you are correct. That's typically my favorite creature of Halloween, but I've never actually dressed as a vampire for Halloween. I'm gonna have to do that one year. So now the next creature. This one might be a tough one. So this next creature usually walks around really slow like this. Sometimes their skin is really nasty. It'll peel off. And sometimes you can see bones because their skin is peeling. And what they like to eat, I've heard that they like to eat human brains. So can anyone tell me what they think that creature is? They walk around really slowly, like they're sleepy. Their skin's really nasty. And that's probably because they've been laying in a tomb for so long, in a casket under the ground. Yep, a zombie, good job. So now this next creature, this next creature turns into a really big animal. Usually when the moon is full, the animal they turn into has a lot of fur. It can run really fast. They look similar to a dog. What do you guys think that is? Again, this creature turns into a really big animal when the moon is full. They have a lot of fur, a lot of teeth, can run really fast. And it looks similar to a dog. Does anyone know what that creature is? Yep, a werewolf. Great job. So now the next one, I wouldn't necessarily call them a creature. So they're more of a person. This person spends a lot of their time on a ship or a boat, and sometimes they have an eye patch covering their eye. They like to go on adventures looking for gold and treasure chests filled with gold and different types of stones. They say "arr" a lot. Who do you think that is? Spend a lot of time on a boat. They wear an eye patch sometimes. Like to go looking for treasures. What else did I say? They say "r" a lot. Yep, a pirate. A pirate. A pirate. Okay. Last one, you guys. Are you ready? So, this person, it's another person. Usually when they come, they can be invited to birthday parties and they seem really nice. But during Halloween, they're really creepy. So they have a really big nose, red nose. Sometimes they have really big shoes. They like, their face is usually painted white. Really big, colorful hair. And I think it's pretty common that people are scared of them. Like, it's a really big fear. Yep, clowns. Good job, you guys. And that was our last one. Oh, I forgot to go over the National Day. So, does anyone know what today is? According to the National Day website. What is it again? Oh, today is National Candy Corn Day. National Candy Corn. I'm not really a big fan of candy corn, but some people love it. I like chocolate a lot. So, the sign that I want to show you guys for today's National Day is candy. So the sign for candy is really easy. You just want to bring out your pointer finger and you're gonna bring it to the side of your mouth and you're gonna twist your finger like that. And that is the sign for candy. So again, pointer finger, side of your mouth or your cheek, and twisting your finger. Candy. Well, thanks everyone for watching. That'll conclude live for today. I'm really sad that I couldn't come into the ARC today, but I miss everyone and I hope to see you all soon. Bye.